You smell that? That's the universe, son. I love the smell of the universe in the morning. Hello everyone, Julian here for DNews from YouTube Space LA. Space is awe-inspiring, and whether you're looking at high-resolution photos of Andromeda from Hubble, or just staring at the night sky through your open window, it's a feast for the eyes. But have you ever wondered what the universe smelled like? It's a very Jaden Smith question, I know, but a valid one nonetheless. Well, fortunately for us, we have sent people into space equipped with the latest in nose technology, and they've told us what space smells like. Now, obviously they're not smelling space while they're in the middle of spacewalks, because in order to smell, chemicals would have to reach the olfactory sensory neurons inside their nose. So if they're smelling the universe from inside their suit, that means space is getting in, and that's kind of the opposite of what the suit was designed for. But when they get back inside the airlock and take their helmets off, the star stank clings to their suits, and there have been a couple different comparisons depending on who you ask. NASA's Kevin Ford said his spacewalk smelled like nothing he's smelled before, but he'll never forget it. Don Pettit, an astronaut aboard the ISS, was a little more descriptive and described it as a sweet, pleasant, metallic smell, and it reminded him of his summers he spent welding. Alexander Gerst of the European Space Agency said it's a mix of walnuts and the brake pads of his motorbike, but he also described it as a pile of wet clothes after a day in the snow, which sounds drastically different from his other description. And space tourist Anusha Ansari said the smell reminded her of burnt almond cookies. Apparently, space odor is the most nostalgia-inducing thing ever. So what makes space intersmeller? Polycyclic aromatic hydrocarbons. They're rings of hydrogen and carbon that are abundant in the universe, and they're associated with new stars. They form easily, can be found on comets and meteorites, are in burned steak, and they give some nebula their red hue. It's estimated 20% of the carbon in the universe is tied up in polycyclic aromatic hydrocarbons, and it's possible they're the seed for life as we know it. Pretty crazy, right? Of course, if you go elsewhere, there may be different smelly smells that smell smelly. Like on the moon, for example. Buzz Aldrin compared the smell of moon dust to slightly damp ashes in a fireplace. And fellow Apollo astronaut Harrison Schmitt described it as spent gunpowder. And based on the spectrums we've analyzed from the center of our galaxy, the dust cloud Sagittarius B2 is silly with ethyl formate, meaning it smells like rum. I think that's only further evidence of space pirates. Like I said, you wouldn't want to smell space by floating around in it unprotected because of your imminent death, but it wouldn't be as quick or horrible as you might think. Trace covers that down here. So, any other offbeat questions about space you want us to cover? Let us know in the comments, or find me on Twitter at jhug00, and I'll see you next time on DNews.